Let's understand a stationary waves on a clamped rod. So we are having a rod made up of some metal having length L, it is clamped at its middle point. And say if the rod is made to oscillate by hammering on it. And as soon as we hammer it, obviously the wave starts propagating from one end of the rod to the other end, and it will be reflected back and forth, and it may produce stationary waves. And obviously as the middle point is clamped, it must be a node. And at open end, we can say as the waves are reflected from air, or we can say these are reflected from the closed end of the rod, we can say an anti node is obtained here. So due to hammering, the wave of maximum wavelength which can be established is in such a way that at the two ends, two anti nodes are obtained, and at the middle point a node is obtained. This will be the maximum possible wavelength which can be established in form of stationary waves in the rod for transverse oscillations. And as we know that two adjoining antinodes have a separation lambda by 2. So here length can be written as lambda by 2, or we can write lambda as 2L. So in this situation, oscillation frequency can be calculated as N0, which can be written as V by lambda, and wavelength is given as 2L. So for solid metal rod, the longitudinal oscillations which will exist in it, the wave velocity can be written as root of Young modulus by density. So this will be the fundamental frequency of oscillation, we can say, which will exist in it. And if we talk about the first overtone, this can be written as the fundamental frequency, because this is corresponding to maximum wavelength or minimum frequency it will be. If we talk about the first overtone, and for the very next situation when a stationary wave can exist in the rod, which is clamped at the middle point, is the one when one node on the two sides will be introduced, because the middle point will still be kept as a node. So situation would be this. One node will be introduced on either side of the rod. So we can say now in this situation, if L is its length, L can be written as 3 lambda by 2, or correspondingly the value of wavelength will be 2L by 3, and if we find out the frequency, it is V by lambda, it is 2L by 3. It is 3 times the fundamental frequency, which can be written as third harmonic oscillation. So again we can say in case of a rod which is clamped at the middle point, at second harmonic frequency, stationary waves can never be established. So no resonance will occur, or oscillations will damp out if it is made to oscillate at second harmonic. Similarly, if we talk about its second overtone, the next possible frequency at which the stationary waves can be established here will be the one when two nodes are extra introduced on either side of the clamp. So situation would be this, which I am drawing here. In this situation, this length can be written as 5 lambda by 2, and correspondingly wavelength will be 2L by 5. So this will correspond to a frequency V by lambda, which is 2L by 5. It is 5 times the fundamental frequency, it is the fifth harmonic. So we can say in case of clamped rod, resonance can exist at all odd harmonic frequencies of the fundamental, and this fifth harmonic we can write as second overtone, because this is the second possible frequency at which stationary waves can exist after fundamental frequency.